Welcome, everybody. Welcome. Thanks for your patience. I know it's hot out here. Hang in there. If you have cell phones, everybody has a cell phone, check it real quick. Make sure it's on silent. The wedding party is going to join us here really quickly, and we'll get this underway. Thank you.
Chad got in touch with me because he wanted to let me know what a big fan you are, and that's just so appreciated. I just thank you so much for that. I understand you and Chad have been dating for 3 years now, so congratulations on that. And to that point, I have a very, very special question to ask you. Natalie Rodriguez, will you marry Chad Drum?
Every breath you take, every move you make, every bond you break, every step you take.
Thank you. Please be seated.
We're like a wreck.
They're a little bit of a wreck, but it's really good. And I told Chad, if you're going to cry, cry on your wedding day. It's totally appropriate. And I stand by that. I really believe that. And I love it when the groom cries. Natalie's super thirsty, by the way. Ready? Dearly beloved, honored guests and friends, we're invited here today. No kissing until the very end, okay? There's rules here. We're invited here today because of the strength of love and of promises kept to share with Natalie and Chad in a very important moment in their lives. As they open a new chapter, filled with support, laughter, loyalty, friendship, and love. This is a day when two lives are made one, when two halves become a whole, when two very best friends have the absolute privilege of becoming a husband and a wife. Long time coming. People are cheering already. Before we get into the serious stuff, all the vows and the agreements and all the forevers and all that stuff, Natalie and Chad have asked me to tell you a little bit about how they met and how their lives were tied together since that very first day. Since the very first day, and now having seen Chad, I can totally see why. You guys will appreciate this. The evening Natalie and Chad were going to meet for the first time and go on their very first date together, there was a huge snowstorm. The snow was up to Natalie's front door, and since she was afraid to drive in the snow, Chad offered, can I say that to them? Do you want me to narrate what you just said?
No.
I'll leave that out. Okay, Chad offered to come 45 miles at night in the snow just to meet her for the very first time. And when Natalie opened the door, the two finally met eye to eye for the very first time. They vividly remember being overcome with so much love and immediately felt that they had found their person in life. It was kismet. Love at first sight. That's a strange thing, but there's no other way to describe it. It's kind of a cliche, but it was truly love at first sight. One of the first things Chad said to Natalie was, I'm going to marry you. And here we are. Since that day, February 22nd, 2018, they have spent every day and every night together, and that feeling of immense love they share for one another has only continued to grow stronger with each day together. That's a good sign, by the way. Off script, that's a good sign. Over the past 4.5 years, they have had one adventure after another together, from home remodels to traveling and concerts and building their farm full of loving animals. These two share such a tight bond that there are many times that no words are needed. They both just know what the other one wants and needs. Their hopes, dreams, and goals in life are the same, and with that, they know their life together is going to be a beautiful and successful love story. Natalie and Chad share the joy of raising Chad's son, Sid, together and have created hundreds of amazing memories together with him and have watched him grow into an amazing young man who they are very, very proud of. Their love for growing their family started with their beautiful son, Zane Fletcher Drum. This wedding was planned around him. And even though he is not able to be here today, this one's for you, boo-boo. We're here today. Yeah, that's worth it. That's worth it. Hang on to each other. It's totally worth it. We're here today to celebrate Natalie and Chad's love for one another, their love for life, and the love for their children, Sid and Zane. Here's to many more adventures. Long talks, loving hugs, and endless laughs and smiles together. Here's to love at first sight. Well said. We can cheer that, for sure. Oh, a handkerchief. There we go. Cloud cover. See, it's meant to be. More of this meant to be stuff. Okay, not meant to be. Okay, great story. There's something important about that stuff. You'll remember that stuff, and you'll probably want to return to that stuff a lot. And I'll talk about that a little bit later in the ceremony. Your roots are important. Your love is important. The feelings that you feel are important. They can feel fleeting sometimes. They'll move in and out. Like, there's going to be some times when you're going to want to punch the dude in the face, right? There's going to be times when you're going to want to run away from her because it gets scary as hell. And that happens, and it's fine. You just got to return to each other. You got to find... Yeah, no, no. You got to find each other. Seriously, you got to find each other through all the noise and all the muck. You just have to find your very best friend. You have to hug him. You have to say, this is so important. I love you so, so much. Okay, not to script anything for you, but there's your answer, okay? I'm gonna cry too. Let's all cry together. If there's ever a day to do it, today's the day. Natalie, Chad, the commitments you are about to agree to represent a promise you make to honor the love and friendship you have already grown, to trust the goals and commitments you share, to respect one another as individuals, whether you're together or apart, and to spend the rest of your lives together, chasing each other's dreams, chasing each other's bands, chasing each other around the kitchen, whatever cute thing you want to do. All those things, and more, okay? This union allows two separate souls to share all their desires, dreams, and memories, their joys and sorrows, no fear of judgment, knowing that their love for each other will help guide them through all the uncertainties of life. You guys made it through 2020. That was a bear of a year. It's a hard, hard thing that you guys made through. Look, nobody wants it to happen, but if it happens again in 2030 or 2040, you've been through it and you got your personal lean on. And that's a really important feature of this, to have somebody that's there that you can trust and rely on and lean on. That's a really important thing. And it's actually a really rare thing. It's a privilege. And I'll say this several times too, take very good care of it. You take very good care of this lady, okay? You take very good care of this good, good man, okay? So what we're about to do is symbolic of many things. The wedding ceremony consists of a number of symbols that are designed to remind you of the pledge you make, to always turn toward each other, not away, to always work through your struggles rather than run from them, to always pause, breathe real deep sometimes, remain centered in your mutual respect for each other. Anytime you may lose sight of your love, there's going to be times, there's going to be noise, there's going to be distractions. That's life. You just have to find each other through all of it, somehow. Expressing these vows today is evidence of the trust and faith you have in the constancy of your friendship and the confidence in the direction your lives will take. Inviting your loved ones to celebrate with you today signifies a commitment to your relationship, and my favorite part, the shared conviction that you are better together than you are apart. Okay, in a lot of ways it's actually easier to go it alone. But to find somebody that kind of ignites something in you, this will make me cry. That burns something inside of you. That's a really special thing. And to find somebody that's willing to just walk through this madness with you, that's crazy. And it's super important. It's super important. I love you guys. And the wedding ring itself serves as a reminder of the wholeness of the love you share, the unending, undying nature of the devotion you have between you, and the eternal bond that we're creating right now, we're building up right now. You'll take them off sometimes out of necessity. Okay, that's okay. It's totally okay. Always put them back on. If you're away from each other, if you're in different cities, reference the ring. Think about each other. Think about your commitments. Think about your family. Think about what you've done. Okay? There's some real power to that symbol. Sid, can we get the rings? Can we hear it for Sid? Chad, you want to take Natalie's ring? That's perfect. I'll make it easy to go on. Okay, Chad, as you place this ring on Natalie's finger, please repeat after me, okay?
With this ring, I give you my promise to honor you, protect you, and adore you for the rest of forever.
Forever and ever. Okay. Left hand, fourth finger, northern hemisphere, this is stuff. Okay, Natalie, a little bit different, but the same kind of thing. Okay, repeat after me, please.
With this ring, I give you my promise to honor you, respect you, and inspire you for the rest of forever.
Okay. So it's always strange. There's transitions in the ceremony, and I'm like, good job, way to go. Okay, nice work. Sorry about that. That's just kind of how it goes. So here's another one. Okay, good. Remember those things. Remember what you just did. Remember what you just said. It's important. Okay, that's important stuff. When you go off into the real world, a lot of the magic of today will kind of fade away. It'll be real in your memories, but it'll fade a little bit. You'll get into a routine, and that's okay. It's actually really a good thing. But you have to figure out some way to access this feeling, this electricity, this magnetism, this magic, whatever you want to call it. You have to figure out how to access this, because you're going to need it. There's going to be times when you're going to absolutely need it. With all that said, please remember that not everyone is lucky enough to find their soulmate. Not everyone has the honor of having their best friend by their side. Please remember that honesty, teamwork, hard work, compassion, an amazing sense of humor, a love of music, those are the pillars of a happy and enduring home. Love each other as you are, continue to grow together, but always return to the foundations upon which your love has long since been built, in order to remain true to each other and the commitment you have agreed to make to each other today. Access this, okay? Somehow, manufacture it, get back to this moment, because this is a really special moment, okay? As you grow your friendship, this is what I mentioned earlier, life is gonna fill itself with distractions. It's not your fault, it's just kind of how things are. It does it for everybody. Never forget to enjoy the adventure, okay? Always find reasons to celebrate. Good, look, you just did it. It's a great example. Oh, there's a flower, there's a butterfly, I like that thing. Yes. Oh, is it? Oh, good, I like that. Good. It was a little bit of an ADD moment, but it's still okay. I mean, it's your wedding day, but it's your wedding day. Continue to look for ways to nurture your marriage and your friendship and your relationship with shared joys, whatever those are, simple and complex, and that will ensure you have an amazing life together. 60 years, 70 years, 100 years, however long it is, that lifetime together that you guys get to be together. It's magic. That's magic. That's special. But that's not all. When that happens, when the distractions come, when the noise is there, I would advise you to remind each other how important it is. Too important to not treat dearly each other, relationship. Take time out if you have to. Pause if you have to. Walk away for a minute if you have to. Be an adult if you really have to. It's hard to do in the moment. Just know there's not very many things that saying I love you won't solve. It's kind of a get out of jail free card a little bit, sort of. When you want to say I hate you, you got to say I love you instead, okay? Just know there's not very many things that can't be solved by swallowing your pride, being wrong, even when you know you're right. And if that happens, it's going to happen. It goes away forever. You never ever bring that up. You just take that one for the team. It's super important. Okay, and for everything else, if you're ever distracted, if you're ever annoyed, remember today. Remember the magic of today. Remember this magenta suit and this black wedding dress and this magic that you guys have created. Okay, and that'll get you back to center when everything else is noisy and in your way. Okay, you'll need those things in some trying times. Okay? That's all I got. You ready to go? Here's the real deal. Ready for the real deal? You're gonna cuss? You're gonna kiss? Okay, here we go. Good. You wanna say it in the microphone? Good. I appreciate that enthusiasm. I like it. Natalie, do you take this man? Do you take this good, good man to be your lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, in good times and in bad, committing yourself unto only him, for now and forever?
Oh, hell yeah, I do forever.
Chad. Good, Chad. Now you gotta one-up that somehow. Chad, do you take this woman, do you take this good, good woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, in good times and in bad, committing yourself unto only her, for now and forever? Excuse the language, but fuck yeah, I do! Good. Good. Good job. Well done. Appreciate that. It's how it should be, whether you say it out loud or just feel it in your heart. I appreciate that. Okay. Well done. You guys are here today of your own free will in the presence of family or friends. You said some pretty cool things to each other. The sentiment was there. You've given them, exchanged some rings. Remember these things. Please take very, very good care of each other, okay? By the authority vested in me, by the state of Utah. I'm pleased to pronounce you husband and wife, Chad. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Drum. Congratulations. Again, for hanging in there. I know it's really warm out here. To the north, to your left, to my right, that barn over there, that's where the reception's gonna be. You can adjourn there, cool off, open bar, have a drink, relax a little bit. The wedding party's gonna go take some pictures and sign some papers, and they will join you for congratulations in just a minute. Thanks very much.